All right, here's a quick little video showing a couple of the animals and just right in situ in their different enclosures. So this one's actually one of my holdback animals. So this is, it's kind of smeared on the end, but this is a T positive matrix genetic stripe. And this is right in his cage. He's due for a little bit of a water change. I do provide hide boxes for these guys for a certain point. This guy's actually getting to a point where he's a little too big for this tub, so he's going to be upgrading shortly. This is a male. This is, like I said, one of my holdbacks. So give you a perspective. Genetic striping, if you could kind of tell, you'll see the vertebral striping there. This is a matrix. It's a little hard to tell from this angle, but definitely when you look at the side of the face, you see the pixelation around the edges, not the smooth rosettes that you typically see with a traditional non-matrix animal. I can't look at the tongue on the albinos because the albino already has a pink tongue, as does the matrix. And the superform, which of course is the ivory. So, but this one's a genetic stripe matrix T positive albino. This one's actually a male. Opted to hold this guy back because I could use him to plug into some other projects. Outside of that, I have, this is a genetic stripe T positive. This one's a female. So she also glows phenomenal. Now she's more expression of the genetic striping, as you can tell along the vertebral stripes. Typical with this VPI genetic stripe line is you'll see like almost like a parallel branch off of the striping. She's got the reduced pattern along the sides here. So if you look along that side where you start losing a little bit of the pigment color, that's likely the influence of the hypogene that's running in this bloodline. So this one's also a T positive. This one, however, does not express strongly the matrix look, so it's not a matrix, or at least that's, it's really hard to tell matrix albinos, as I mentioned. But this is a wonderful animal as well. And that one just happens to be F-manophora. And then I've got a regular T positive, so this one's a female as well. This is one of two babies that came out of one egg. This was the smaller of the two, came in at 21 grams. Okay, so you would expect it to be smaller. Kind of give you a perspective. So now what I like about this one, and it's ironic that it was one of the twins, this one, you'll see the strong lavender coloration along the back of the back of the tail here. That's typical with at least this line of the T positive. We see that with a couple other ones. So where there's a strong black pigment, you'll see that pronounced as a lavender color. And that, just like the grandfather, Lestat, who has a strong lavender coloration in there. Now this one, I'm not saying this one's genetic stripe. It's got some striping in there, but it's not as pronounced. But this one very well could be an expression of the T-positive genetic stripe. I'm not listing it as that, though it is at least a het genetic stripe because the sire was a visible genetic stripe. So you can kind of get an idea of the head, especially with the back. You'll see along the back of the head there, the real nice red coloration on the upper brows. This is going to be a really outstanding looking animal when it gets older. So it kind of puts it in context of the different variations within the albino gene. And as you can tell, that one has a hide box, even though it doesn't fit. It seems kind of funny, but it actually works for him. And I actually might have this. So this, I've got a normal. This is a visible genetic stripe matrix. But this is a normal. This is not obviously an albino, but this is this one would be a possible het T positive albino as well. And now this one's got real strong genetic stripe appearance, and this one's clearly matrix, as you can tell by the speckling on the side and the pixelation on the upward, probably third to half of the body. So really, really fascinating expressions of the matrix in this clutch. So put it in context of the different animals you see in some of these mixed gene breedings that I've been doing. And of course, this is a female. This was actually the largest out of all of them, came in at 92 grams. So we got a range of 92 grams on the high end to 21 grams on the twin. So hope you enjoyed it. It's always fun to be able to see the different babies. Thanks.